Now, in the last video, I showed you the DXCommander Rapide and how I designed that antenna in software. In this video, I'm going to show you how we've built this, where you can buy it from, what the SWR curves look like, how well it operates. Then we'll go back to the bunker and I'll plot it out in software and you can work it out whether this is the antenna for you. The whole principle of this is it's built around six elements on some hexagonal plates. Each element goes straight up the pole, and to make up the difference between the element and where the next plate is, we use Marlow marine quality shock cord. And my goodness, this will even do CB as well. But the surprise to me is that it gets a perfect tune on the 4 meter band. Depending on your country, you may have 4 meters. It works on two. I was opening repeaters and I even spoke to a fella, Mick, actually 7 miles away, who was using a handy 5 and 5 with me on 5 watts. Lots coming up. Stick with the program. But let's start with a build. In the kit, we've got a 7 meter pole. We've got some DX10, 100 meter reel, 330 feet, which we use for both the elements, and some small radials. Okay, only 3 meters, whatever that is in feet, 3.2 meters I was using, and I've built 24 of those, and nice and easy to handle. You go and get a kit with all the plates, so that'll be the ground plate, driven plate, guy plate, a mid spreader and an upper spreader. In that kit also comes with an SO239 assembly, which you fit in onto the plate. Obviously, screw all the stainless bolts into the plates. You'll find you'll always get one extra bolt. All right, and if you don't get an extra bolt, it means you've still got enough. Use a 10 mil spanner just to tighten them up without stripping the threads. That's a set or forget. You'll never need to play with that again, because we can then put a washer over the top and spin a wing nut down for your fork connectors. You see, you put your radials in there and the elements. I thoroughly recommend you make your elements first. I'll show you a cut chart at the end of this video to show you exactly how long your elements need to be. A little tip though, cut them that much too far, put your fork connector on, put your glue lined heat shrink on. I use some fancy cube markers that I found for kids' bracelets. I just thought it was cool. Then once you've got the fork connector in place, measure halfway down the fork connector to the very end, then you can cut it exactly, because if you make a bit of a cock up stripping the wire, you're just cutting into the little bit of spare that you made for yourself at the very beginning. I've calculated on this antenna, you put a 6 centimeter loop. 6 centimeters is that many inches. The next bit is to keep the elements nice and taut. We use shock cord, 4 millimeters, which is just under 1/4 inch. You slip over a little ferrule thing, put a knot in it so it doesn't come off, and then you clip your carabiner together. Now, if it's clipped in together, you can go to full stretch on Marlow shock cord and it should never come undone. I used to say to people, don't over tension your shock cord, but Marlow shock cord is so nice that on mine, I have literally gone to the last, there's only about that much tension left. They're tight, okay? I mean, they're very, very taut, tight, whatever you want to say. I've tensioned them right up to the sort of max. Now, once you've got 6 elements pulling that hard down on the pole, it's going to have the inclination to collapse. What I did is I used 1.5 wraps of self-amalgamating tape on each of the joins, and then went twice round with a bit of 3M electrical tape. Now, mine's been up now for over a week under full tension and it's not come down. You see, when you do that, it stops water ingress getting inside, little beasties, microbiology starting to grow inside that crack. And then you get ice, water, heat and everything else, it'll come apart. I didn't really come up with this for a true portable solution, but if you're a bit of a caravanner or a bit of a camper, if you know what I mean, and you want it up for a night, it should handle it fine. Just remember to really pull out each section, give it a really good twist, and you'll be fine. Have some sympathy for the engineering behind this. If you do the shock cord like I did, it's going to have a lot of downward force, that's all. Right, 30 metres. 30 metres goes up to the 5 metre point where the 20 metre element is under tension with shock cord. And you do the same. You tension your 30 meter element there with a loop that goes up and then up again. All right. Then it goes all the way to the top, all the way back down to the upper spreader again. And then a little bit more shock cord. And to stop the thing floating around the last two sections, we supply a little bit of aquarium tube of different sizes. You just slip them over And that will just keep the elements nice and tight. I was very excited because this is my first antenna we've got in the new field at Holly Farm. I was very happy with the 24 radials. And back at base, after having a twiddle around with the radio and the new SWR meter, it's the stick. Well, let's show you the SWR curve. So on 30 meters, it's negligible. 20 meters. You've got to remember, 20 meters is quite big. So you've got from 14 all the way up to 14,350. So there's 350 kilohertz. You've got to choose your poison here. I tuned mine for 14.2. That will still do FT8. But if you want to go all the way down to 1400, you might want to make it a little bit longer. You'll find on my website the SWR calculator, where you put in what length your antenna is now and what frequency your antenna is now and where you want to aim at. And it'll tell you whether you want to add a little bit or take away a little bit. So you don't have to do the maths yourself. That's reliable. That's how I built this antenna, because I was off a little bit here and there, and I just used my own calculator to work out whether I needed to cut a bit off. 18's fine, 15's fine, 12 is absolutely perfect, 10 is fine. You'll notice at the top of 10, the 30 meter element starts working again as a three quarter wave. So you've got this almost flat SWR curve from 28.2-ish usable up through 28.5, right up to 29.5. Now, obviously, you can move that down 200 kilohertz using the SWR calculator. That's up to you if you wanted to do CW and voice, for instance. 6 meters, the ATU button worked, and I haven't got an amplifier for 6 anyway, so it didn't really bother me. The SWR meter tuned on 4 meters. So on that, I know some of the UK boys like 4 meters. I got this tuned on 2, as I said. It was amazing. And then I had a little play around. So I bumped into, the first time ever, I actually heard someone on 12 meters. Well, say the first time. Ages since I've heard anybody on 12 meters. They were having a laugh, these two guys. One was in Ireland. I can't remember the other guy. The other guy was a Papa Alpha station, I think. 10 meters was open last week. You probably remember it. Probably still is. I don't know. There was people from all over the place. There was some local stuff as well. When I say local, I mean 100, 200 mile stuff going on. That was great fun. You could hardly find a frequency at some points in time. I pumped into Simon, G4TVR, who's about 10 miles away. Now, I'm pleased. I was doing 200 watts, and he says I'm 5.9 plus, which means the hugging, the low to the ground, right? That DX capability that I'm after is working. In other words, my signal wasn't going straight up. All in all, a complete success. I wonder if, I mean, I'm not going to get a tune on 40 meters. It's not designed for 40. But I looked at the meter, and it was only 6 to 1 SWR, which is, you know, fairly high. Most modern radios will tune 6 to 1 SWR on your ATU button, by the way. But I did make a contact. I heard this guy, give him a call, and that was fine.
From my side to you, near Birmingham, I think Mike Zero, Mike Charlie, sorry, there's a Kilo 8.4 with me.
And you won't be losing much power at 6 to 1 SWR anyway. And if you want 40, we've got a different solution for that anyway. What you do is you go all the way up to the very top. You don't use 30 meters. And you come all the way back down to the guy point. That gives you 40, but I haven't done that yet with the 6 elements. Well, that'll be 5 elements, won't it? Because 40 uses up 2 of them. Be assured it will do 40. I know it will do 40. I just don't know what impact that's going to have on somewhere around 11 metres. It will give us another tune, you see. All right, let's head into the software now. Move this out of the way. This is my little mixing software, which a lot of people ask me what it is. It comes with a Behringer X-Air 18. It's not just software you can buy or download. It comes with the mixing desk. This is MMANA, and a lot of you will remember me, and a lot of you have come across my channel because of software modeling, what I've done in the past. Reopen Rapide Mark 1, and here it is here. I can zoom in a bit. You can see I've just built a little hexagonal plate. You don't need to know how MMANA works. The far field plots are normally pretty well. I haven't found a far-field plot which conflicts with reality. Anyway, let's just run through the calculations. So on 10.12, as you can see on SWR curve, I've got 1.34 here. And as you can see, we're getting an absolute perfect quarter wave pattern here, and you'll know from experience, if you watched my channel before, that at 175 degrees off the horizon, 5 degrees off the horizon, we should be getting about minus 5 dB. I'm not going to go into why I'm into 5 degrees off the horizon. That's a quarter wave. Any quarter wave will give you about that, depending on the odd soil conditions and so on. So although it sounds a bit cruddy, minus 4.9, it says here in the middle of the screen, don't be worried about that, okay? It's just a baseline. Just a baseline. I've tuned this, I think, for 14200. That should give us about minus 5 as well, minus 5.2. So we're getting the 17 meter band as well, minus 5.3. 15 meters, minus 5.2. 12 meters, 175, minus 5. And 10 meters, minus 3.8. Slightly better there because we've got all the other elements interacting with it, pushing the donut slightly flatter. Let's do 145 megahertz. So at 5 degrees off the horizon. So we're 6 dB better than a quarter wave, which is why I was hearing Mick 7 miles away with his 5-watt walkie-talkie thing. And I was opening all the repeaters. It's tremendous. You don't want, I mean, this is all right at the top here, but it's only ever any good if you wanted to talk to either satellites or International Space Station. There we are, the ideal antenna for you. I just finished recording this video in one take and forgot to show you the 5/8 business with the CB. So I've created a 12 meter quarter wave, I've created an 11 meter quarter wave, and then for the 30 meter band, I've used that for 10 meters by going up and coming back down a little bit. By coming back down a little bit more than I've done in the field now. And what that's giving us is a plot on the 12 meter band at minus 4.3 at 27.353, say, because a lot of people like to use this on CB. We're getting a plot that looks really nice, minus 2.4. And then on 28.5, we've got a plot. And look at these SWR curves here, 1.11. It looks a bit of a cloud warmer up here, but watch for it. Down at 175, minus 2.3. So we are, in the main, the 10-meter and 11-meter band are about 3 dB, which is like taking 100 watts and making it into 200 watts. So that's exactly the same on your receive. You'll be receiving twice as well. So I'm looking forward to putting that hack in. I'm also looking forward, and wouldn't it be great if you're not a digital guy, you're not into FT8, say, on 30 meters, you could have a 40, 20, 17, 15. You would. You'd hit your ATU button. So if you did it this way, in fact, with your ATU button, you would get 40. You'd still get 30 because 30 with this new variant is only 3.43 to 1 SWR ATU button, you know, 40, 30, 20. Even you get everything. You get 12, 10, 11, 6, 4, 2, and 70. Okay, you don't get 80. Well, buy some more cake, sir. I think this is an antenna for everybody. It really is. It's my favouritest antenna yet. Buy one of these so we can carry on eating and paying the rent around here. It's coming out at £189 plus £40 shipping to the USA. In fact, the rest of the world. Next video to watch is this one. And that's where we designed this in the first place. I will see you on the next video. Bye for now.